Hey, I'm Kev, Kevasicum. Welcome back to Ride Free and the Career Has. Last time we began with the SuperSport 300, it was a bit up and down. As let's go through the results. So we got the 3 stars in Caldwell Park, 3 stars in Tenerife after a redone. Did not get anything. Well, we got 1 star actually from the time attack, and then we got 3 stars in the night race. And then nothing at Donington. So we've got to go back to Donington and to the time attack. But this time I said we're going to do the 2-stroke. 125cc Little Legends. The past. The decade spanning 1990-2000 is known by all as the golden hour of 2-stroke 125cc bikes. In those years, owning a 125 was a real status symbol for a teenager. Something which new generations may never fully understand. For those who lived through it, 125cc bikes represented a dream come true. A gateway into the world of sport bike. So a bit like with the Super Sports, we've got 3 single races, a night race and a time attack to do. We go to Brands Hatch and the Indy circuit, we go to Okayama and the short circuit, then to Vallelunga, and it looks like it is the very short circuit as well, then the Autonomo di Francescordia, again it looks like that's a kind of a short circuit, and then we've got the very short circuit of the Nürburgring for the time attack. So shall we begin with Brands Hatch, as we've got the Ghetto 125cc bike. So what is available? So we can get the Aprilia RS125 or the RS125R. What is the difference? Just maximum torque to 9,000 and then 11,000, but it seems like this Aprilia has the better stats. And they've got Honda NSR125R, the Suzuki RG125F, or the Yamaha TZR125R. So it actually looks like the first bike we looked at, the Aprilia, was the best. So you've got to complete modern superbikes to get this, and again, legendary 250cc's to get that bike. So let's go with the first bike, Aprilia RS125. So you've got some different paint schemes. So we just go with the, or we can go with the PlayStation livery. Let's go just with the classic Aprilia livery. Yes, we want to purchase something for once. Yes, there it is. Look at it from all angles. It's so quick. No, they're like having to zoom in on it all the time. That is a lovely looking bright though. 1999 Aprilia RS125. And we do want to set that as our main vehicle. It's less than 2 months after conquering 1998 Riders World Championship at 125 category with Katsudo Sakata. Aprilia unveiled the 3rd series RS125 bikes at the Bologna Motor Show. Especially this event is remembered for the introduction of the teardrop rear seat cowl instead of the traditional high tail, along with the windscreen with 1 air scoop, a new front modguard and a Naya fairing. The 2-stroke single cylinder engine with 124cc lamella induction is reduced to satisfy Italian market standards, therefore fed by 28mm carburetor. As yet, the distinctive trait of the bike is the chassis, which is just as good as any GP125 of the late 90s. In other words, same story, 125kg banking is extremely enjoyable. And it goes into all the forks and all the geometry for the suspension and the brake system as well. But this is one of the classic 125cc bikes. And we're going to see how it does round Brands Hatch. And so we are for the first time around this classic English circuit. As let's see how many opponents we've got. Have we got 12 opponents again? We do. We're starting 8th. So I'll do this only once this time, as they've shown it all the time, because it does get a bit repetitive. So the bike setting, so to get rid of the understeer, we have to lower the front ride height. Can be a bit bumpy around Brands Hatch, maybe put it up 1. And then rear ride height, the bike oversteers necessary to lower the rear ride height. But I think we just keep it the same, maybe lower it slightly. And then gearing, we basically want these quite short, actually. There's a bit of a long straight, but apart from that, maybe keep it at 110. And then keep that aggressive and fast. And then I don't think we can do anything with the steering. So let's get going. Oh, hang on. Before I do that, race settings. So someone said, let's set this onto extreme and then just turn this down to 95, should we? Just keep it at 95 for the time being. Off track aid off, pro, anti-reading, manual tucking, off, off. Get rid of anti-reading. There we go. Then everything else is how I would normally have it. So that is our new settings then, which is basically just the same as last time. But we are lined up then. Well, I guess another two lap race or three laps. It is two laps. As we get a decent start. As it gets a bit packed towards Paddock Hill Bend. As you use a bit of the dirt to get through the corner as well. And now into Druids. Looking down the inside. I saw they all run right, clipping the curb as you go into Graham Hill now. Got too good a run. Right in the back of someone. As oh, get into the rider for third. Leader struggled there. So trying to go around the outside of the Honda with an Aprilia. I see drag race towards the line. Dip back for some slipstream. And then try and cut back through Paddock. Oh, easy. Easily done. So you might actually have to up the difficulty to at least 100 now. Once again, and I was saying that when we did our first race last time, it was easy, and then it got a bit more difficult. So I'm not sure if that would be the case again. But we put it up to 100 for the next race, as it's one out of one in the 125cc bikes. Oh yes. Yes, it sets in the words. That doesn't mean we've won in Brands Hatch. That's what all those achievements are in the bottom right. If you're wondering, just wins around different circuits. Even though I did the night race and I haven't unlocked the night race achievement. I don't know why that is. But as you can see, our bike is right up there with performance, up with the Prius RS125R as well. So it looks like a Prius is the class of the field. So that is Brands Hatch over. Now we head to Okayama in Japan for another mild course, a very similar course as well for another race. So we are lined up then. Ready and raring to go. For another two lapper. I forgot to change it up to 95. I am an absolute idiot. But let's see how we do then. If it is as easy. Round a course we're not too familiar with. Don't remember ever riding or driving around this layout. Actually, no, I have in iRacing. My rookie MasterCard races. I have gone around this layout. Okay, I'm a host of a couple F1 races, 94 and 95. But it's mostly known for its race in Japan, of course. As we make it three wide. Top two are getting away, unfortunately. St. Cisco on the inside. So once again, that Honda's struggling. Yeah, the best we're going to come is third, I think. Because he just got stuck on the outside there. When we needed the inside. And once again, braked way too much into that first corner. Also, I forgot to do any setup changes for this race as well. That's why we're struggling a bit too, getting a bike into the corners. It's all very wide. That was abysmal. Down the inside, around the outside, 4-4. Don't dive on me, bike. I said don't dive on me. We get out of the final corner. Just not going to achieve third. We needed another of that, really. That's an absolute failure. To get up to rank 32 at least. No stars. What's how fast is that? He is right up there. So let's replay this, but actually put the setup on the bike and actually change the difficulty. As we've actually changed it to 99 difficulty. And we do have the setup on the bike now. So let's see how we do then. So we've got to watch out for third. That's the bike we've got to clear early. As the top two can just race away if he's still in third. It's a really glue to the back of that rider now. And see much more aggressive than on this occasion. Well done on running wide. I saw they all ran right into that right hand. I like the sweeping lines there. Totally did not go down the inside of the corner. Need to go down the start finish straight. Also shortened the gearing slightly. So he might top out at the end of the straight, hopefully. Oh, this is a much better run already. And I was struggling to hold on to third at the moment. That won't help. But it's our set to these couple of corners will make or break a win here. So we're down the inside for second. Do we have a nut on the grab first, though? It's easy flat through the penultimate corner. No, brake too much in the final corner. God damn it, I needed to get the bike run wide. Oh, we've got second at least. It's an improvement. Much better on that time as well. I think we're like a second quicker. So, set changes definitely did work then. And we get a couple of stars. Let's see how fast that. Half a second quicker. So yeah, definitely need another attempt. I think third time lucky rounder. Right, it was a fun little course. Stoas, now we've got a night race round Vallelunga. So I'm looking down for the first time at night then on board our 125cc bike. We rev it up. Love it when it doesn't select first gear for me. I have no idea why you're not allowed to choose first before the lights, like you can in, like, MotoGP. Instead of just relying on luck, really, that you've got good reactions or not. So stuck in the midfield. Really dive for fifth, make it work, because it's very twisty, this Vallelunga circuit, compared to Brands and Okayama. Total illegal manoeuvre there. Not off track at all as we go into the final corner. On the power relatively early, but we've got a good chance here. As you've got one star on the board, let's try and make it at least two. And you go into the first corner, looking down the inside of second. not quite alongside. In through the downhill, a bit aggressive on second, but you make it through. As it's been very aggressive this course, aren't we? Using all of the curves and everything to generate speed. And that's why, look at that beautiful run here into the final corner. Can't quite make the move for the win though. Oh, that's disappointing. We should have won this. Instead, we are in second. Oh, we've got another lap. Don't slow down. I should probably look at that counter before these races, you know, that would be actually useful. I thought I got on the gas earlier. Oh, look at that run though. First struggling to get the traction. Already down the inside. Take over that lead. Now heading towards the final corner. Bit too close to the wall there. Might have damaged the helmet a bit, but we do win. So we're not disappointed then. We're actually happy with that result, Hez. You got to rank 35. Get 3 stars. Gorgeous. As he did the fastest out by half a second, it looks like. So next up is the final race then. Round the Frankia Corda track. Easy to pronounce. Oh god, we're on a kart track, are we? As it's daytime again. As we rev it up then. For 3 laps. Yeah. Get a decent start. Look at this, we're up to 6th. Right through the middle of our brothers. Go for the first corner. God, is this Elgarve? God, we're not wrong about this being a kart track. Definitely feels like it at the moment. They're trying to find a way past. Look, third is holding it all up again. That blue bike. Now you found it. Found a way past. God, I don't want to be riding the curves around here. As they somehow escaped the final corner. In third, so at least we've got 1 star then. Now let's see if we can close down this top two. As you can see, our bike's all over the place. You've gained a 10th. Gained more than a 10th. As they're starting the battle as well. It's fantastic for us. Try and gain in this sector. That's where we made the pass previously. There we've got the bike rotated. Totally not off track at all. Totally legal manoeuvre. As it got onto the final lap. See, we gave the places back. The next corner. Then we let second know we're there. And first as well, so try to go down the inside. There's no time penalty for that. Okay, we don't mind that then, as we've just got a couple corners to go. God, getting it down the first really helps there. The engine braking. So you crossed the start. Well, we crossed the finish line. Now we've got to cross the start-finish line, apparently. God, how many finish lines do you want? There's like 3 or 4 of them there. But we win another race. God, this is going much better than the Super Sport bikes. There's another 3 stars. As class are filled by country mile, it really does depend on track the difficulty, and it's like. So finally, it is the time attack round the Nürburgring, round the circle. You don't really see a lot though, as you've got to beat 47 flat to get the 3 stars. And so here we are around the famous German circuit. As we head towards the Schumacher S. Is this flat out? Oh, easy. And then you just go into this kind of slip road in between these parts of the circuit. You can go much quicker downhill. That's in third gear. Now here we go, across the start finish line. So 47 flat. Again, we're giving ourselves 3 laps to beat this. We go downhill into, I think it's just Dulnop curb now. Bit too slow though, should have kept it in third, should have carried a bit more momentum through the corner. But as Lewis Hamilton described, if you have GT Sport, he did a track guide for that. You kind of take 2 apexes for that corner. But you kind of hit it at first. Then you go wide and then you hit it for a second apex. That's what we try to do with our bike. This is not too far off. 47.9. We're under second off. Already 2 stars in the bank. So there you go. First apex, second apex. And then flat out through the Schumacher S. Named after the home hero, Michael Schumacher. And that's much better through that section. Now we braked a bit too much into this corner. Not in the power early enough. So 47.5, we just need another similar improvement, we could get this. God, these time attacks are really difficult. Well, the time attacks, they expect times that at the difficulty I'm playing at, probably wouldn't be trying to aim to get. They're like half a second quicker at the moment. As that's not good, upsetting our bike there. We're going to power early, no! So you get lots of reward, lots of prestige and credits. But only 2 stars. So that is the 125cc class. We've only got 2 events to improve on though. That race in Okayama, which we're close to winning anyway. And then we've got the time attack as well. And we can get the 1995 Honda. We wouldn't want that. But that is another volume done. I'll complete it again after the recording. But next time we've got the icons maybe to attack. The Supermoto, the Heritage Cup, a blast from the 80s, the 2-strokes, the legendary 250s. We can discover the world, the most beautiful country roads and legends of motorcycle, the most successful racing bikes of the 60s and 70s. So, what do we do next time? I think we go to Sport Heritage, I guess, and do some icons. But, thanks for watching and I will see you next time.